Hello, everyone. Robert Saunders here again, and today it's APEX AIOps and the brand new functionality here around cybersecurity. What are we going to look at? Well, we're going to look at APEX AIOps cybersecurity section around misconfigurations, security advisories, and links about how to remediate ransomware detection, and also risk assessment. So let's go ahead and jump in here right now and take a look how all of this actually looks in action. So right out of the gate here, we're at the very top of the APEX AIOps homepage, and we see there's a widget there for cybersecurity. We can take a look at that as a glance. We also have the ability over here in the left nav to go to cybersecurity, and let's start drilling in here. First off, system risk. So we browse into system risk. And then what do we want to filter on? Well, I know of an identifier here of a PowerMax system that I want to look into. So I'm filtering on a system ID into this PowerMax. I can quickly see the misconfigurations, security advisories, ransomware incidents at a glance. But let's go in further. So now we have many options to get these details. We see the misconfiguration screen here. And we see the high-level banner there around the misconfigurations, another banner. And then we can drill into all of these down here, even over at the evaluation plan. And let's open this up. What's interesting is that there is one there that's actually one NIST test that actually passed. Now, more about how to build these plans and attach them to systems here in a little bit further down the road in the demo. So over to security advisories, we can click on one of these articles if we'd like. Back out to system risk. Now I'm going to go over to misconfigurations. Now I see I have a bunch of different misconfigurations here also attached to systems. I can order however I'd like to by any of these attributes inside this GUI. That's awesome. So I'll click into another PowerMax system here. And now I see the misconfigurations. I see there's high and medium and low, but the nice thing here, it's all ordered by severity, and I see a description of the problem, and I see the remediation potentially. And sometimes, many times, there's also links to figure out how to help remediate this, which is awesome. And again, this is all based on the eval tests that we assign to systems, and I'll show you that here in a second. There's another remediation for a medium misconfiguration. Another medium, and then down to low. Excellent. So it's all defined there for us, easy to figure out, easy to navigate through. Again, over to the eval plan. We saw this previously in the other system. We see there's a little deviation for RBAC and how we're going to fix it. There's, again, another what the misconfiguration is and how to remediate. Moving down to audit and accountability, config management, identification and auth, and then system and communication protection. And you see there that that's actually not in the plan. Again, you can custom tailor your evaluation plans per system, per sets of systems, however you'd like to do it. So now let's go over to the policies here, and we'll take a look here in just a second. No security advisories. Now over to policies. So here's how we can not only build templates, we can assign, unassign, or have a plan, enable and disable on groups of systems, certain ones. And we see all the different attributes here and ways to filter by systems, products, plan state using a template. So let's drill into one of these here. I can assign a template if I would like to a system. I can see the model numbers over there, the identifiers, the location, last update time. So there's a lot of attributes around each and every row here that I can really help filter and hone into what kind of evaluation plan I want to enable or disable. So I'll click on the first one here, and I enabled the plan for that system. Super easy. Now you may ask, well, how do I edit these templates? So there's a view or duplicate template. I'm also going to show here in a second about how we can build our own. So here's the template eval plan details. You can again tune these. We saw these earlier. We saw some were in and out of the plan. Now you see here, this plan has them all enabled. Now I'm going to build a new one. So I'll give this template a name, and I'm going to pick a product. I'll pick PowerStore. And then back to the same attributes, the five there, I can assign those accordingly. Super easy. Let's keep moving on to security advisories now. And now in security advisories, there's a place, again, same simple filter. I'm going to filter on critical, and I'm also going to filter on a product in PowerEdge server here. Now I see a couple advisory IDs that are critical with regards to impact. So let's take a look at one of these. I'll click into this advisory ID. And then I see the system where it's located. And now let's go to the security advisories tab, and we can see all the advisories here by impact level, synopsis, action articles that we can actually go out and understand how we can remediate. So let's click on one of these articles here, and you see this opens up a really nice Dell knowledge base article for all the advisory details and how to remediate what got surfaced actually with APEX AIOps. So that's awesome, all right there at your fingertips. Now let's go over to ransomware, the final part of the cybersecurity section here. We have three tabs: new, investigate, and closed. So I'll click on one of the incidents here. And these storage anomalies can be raised in terms of data reducibility. If we see data starting to go down pretty quickly, we may think after some training, it takes about 3 weeks to train these models, we may think there's some sort of ransomware incident going on here. So we're going to flag it for the sysadmins to take a look and maybe potentially take action. So I'll click on the finance storage group here and then view storage group metrics. Oh, look at that. So I have some anomalies, or an anomaly here kind of ending at the bottom there as the data is being reduced pretty quickly. There's all the logging, and I can, with APEX AIOps, I can highlight a section and I can really drill into it here. I love that feature. So now I drilled into this whole section. I'll hover over there where the potential ransomware anomaly is, and then it's all tied to the historical seasonality, which again takes APEX AIOps a few weeks to train in a really good way, so it makes intelligent decisions. And there's the anomaly at the end, and we can correlate date, time, and storage all together. That's, as I mentioned, after 3 weeks, we have a baseline. I can go back into this system, which is a PowerMax for the finance team. I'll drill into the system also here. And last but not least, for these types of incidents, teams can make notes here. Maybe you're handing off to another team to do some more triage after hours or during the day, however your systems work, however your people are monitoring systems work. You can add notes to these incidents and act accordingly. Awesome. Thanks to everyone for watching. I appreciate it.